rebuke and cast out every sickness, diseases, infirmities, pain in your body. I cast them out. Headache, I cast you out in the mighty name of Jesus. I cast every sickness in your body. I cast every pain in your body. I command the pain in your back. I cast them in the mighty name of Jesus. Those people are sleeping sickness. Some people are having sleeping sickness. The enemy is infecting you with sleeping sickness. Therefore, I cast a demon by the power and the blood of Jesus. You demon of sleeping sickness. Yes, treasure, remind me to teach about sleeping sickness. Yes, the demon of sleeping sickness. You are sleeping. Even when you are stopping at the right, you go to sleep. People are hooting you. You sleep all the time. Every demon of sleeping sickness, I curse you. I command you to get out of this person in Jesus' name. I command you, demon, you are a liar. In the mighty name of Jesus, I render you powerless by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, pain in your back, pain in your head, pain in your knees, every pain in your shoulder, every demon of pain that is making pain in your body, all over your body, I command you to get out in the name of Jesus. Out every pain in your body, I cast them out now. In the name of Jesus, I bind you, I cast you, get out. In the mighty name of Jesus, every pain, I know some people are having a lot of pain all over their body. They don't feel like that is their body. Those are demons. They are programmed to torture you, to torment you. That's why I have pronouncement against them. The topic I'm going to talk is called pronouncement prayer against the wicked enemy. I have pronouncement to make against the wicked enemy. The wicked enemy are bad. Therefore, I am calling them. I am speaking to them. You wicked enemy. I am here to pronounce you. I have a pronouncement to make. In the mighty name of Jesus, leave this person. You have been tormenting the person for a long time. Now is your time to get out. In the mighty name of Jesus, if you touch this person again, I will come for you. I will destroy you. I will destroy everything you are doing against this woman, against this man. Jesus Christ has given me power in the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, I'm coming to destroy every activities you are doing against this person. Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. He will destroy every power of darkness. God is destroying everything that is working against you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bind and destroy you, demon, that is tormenting this person. Sickness and diseases, get out in the name of Jesus. Financial breakthrough, I pray that God, those people are looking for finances. Finances breakthrough, speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, my Father, I pray for your business in the mighty name of Jesus. I commit your business into your hand. I pray God to increase clients, increase e-customers in the mighty name of Jesus. You will count the thousand. You are not going to count hundreds. You will need an accountant to help you in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus, I command poverty to get out of your life. Poverty to get out and out in the name of Jesus. I have an announcement to make against poverty. You poverty in the life of this person, I have an announcement against you. I command you to get out of this person. Ancestral poverty, a generational poverty, get out. You are a great enemy. Get out in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, God. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, Jesus. You are a wonderful, you are a great God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I thank you and I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to welcome you once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Today, I'm going to talk to you the subject called Pronouncement Prayer Against the Wicked Enemy. Once again, I'm going to talk to you the subject called Pronouncement Prayer Against the Enemy. You know there is the enemy who needs pronouncement. You have to pronounce against, you have to have a prayer, pronouncement prayer against the enemy. We have example, a man who pronounced a prayer against the enemy. And the enemy was disgraced. And the enemy was disgraced. The whole world would shake their head and said, yes, he made it. So I know that the enemy can disgrace you, can mistreat you, can treat you anything you want because he has power over you. Child of God, the child of the devil can mistreat you, can threaten you, can do you anything they want because they have money, because they are in the position. And you are watching the child of the devil. You watch the child of the devil taking your job, killing your children, making you miserable. That is not acceptable. That's why you need to know pronouncement prayer against the wicked enemies. You have to know how to pronounce a prayer against the wicked enemies. We are going to read the book of 1 Samuel 17, verse 45. To 50. 1 Samuel. The book of 1 Samuel 17, verse 45 to 50. You can see the story here. It is a known story, but the revelation is different. The way you know is very different the way I know. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Here, we saw a man called Goliath. Goliath was a man who disrespected the children of God. Goliath was a man who was cursing the children of God, a child of God. And everybody were running back. When he comes, 40 days, non-stop, every day he was coming to abuse the children of Israel. Now a boy called David, King David, when he looked at that, he said, what is this? Does it mean there is nobody can face this child of the devil? Does it mean there is nobody who can confront this child of the devil? Then David prepared a pronouncement, a prayer against him. He was so wicked. He was a wicked, wicked enemy. There are wicked enemies who have no sympathy. They are a wicked enemy who cannot even spare your child. This enemy is called Goliath. Goliath was disrespected. He didn't recognize the God of Israel. He didn't recognize the God of the children of Israel. So there is power. There is some physical enemies who does not recognize your God. And they don't want even to hear that you have God. They can mistreat you. They can treat you. They can do anything they want because they are on the position. Let me tell you that you have a mouth to pronounce a pronouncement prayer against that wicked. That manager who is abusing you, who is sitting on your job, you can pronounce a prayer against that wicked manager that is abusing you because he's a manager, because he's a director, he sit on your money, your promotion, but he doesn't know that you are a child of God. And it doesn't want you to mention God. They will make you like your God is nothing. You have power. You have power to pronounce. You have power. You have power to pronounce prayer. Pronouncement prayer. You can pronounce a prayer that will disgrace that man or that woman in that position. We have been given power and authority by the power in the blood of Jesus. Don't wait and see that child of the devil abusing you. You can confront them. You can confront that child of the devil. David confronted this giant. And the giant was disgraced and exposed. And even David killed him. So you can destroy completely and kill that enemy that is working against you. You can eliminate the devil, the child of the devil around your life, around your community, around your environment in Jesus' name. Those powers, Goliath was killed physically, but you can kill those powers that is operating against that person, against your manager, against your director. You can command those power behind that man, that woman, you can command them to die and let it go from your life in Jesus' name. Don't watch the enemy take advantage of you, and you might not have anything, because maybe you are poor, you don't have money, you don't have anything. Now the man you are working, you know it is serious. You cannot be abused and being disrespecting because of your God. You have to refuse. You have to say no. No way. There is no way you can do me like this. I will pronounce prayer. You have to know how to do pronouncement prayer that will silence the enemy forever. If David did not know how to pronounce the prayer against this Goliath, nobody was going to kill Goliath except David. Even Saul, Goliath could have killed him. Even those armies of Israel, Goliath could have killed them, all of them. He was a man who he was a giant. He was confronting every day, 40 days, until David had to silence him. And David did not use anything. He only had a stone. And they said, what? What am I hearing? I'm telling you that there's God of heaven. Let's read the book, the 1 Samuel 17, verse 45 to 50. The Bible says, David replied to the Philistine. David replied to the Philistine. You come to me with sword, spear, and javelin. But I come to you in the name of the Lord of heaven's armies, the God of armies of Israel, whom you have defiled. You know, he defiled the God of Israel, the God of heaven, the God of our forefather. He defiled them. He just treated our father like a garbage. He treated our father, God in heaven, like garbage. Today the Lord will conquer you and they will kill you and they cut off your head. You see, he said, today, that is pronouncement prayer now. That is pronouncement he made to David made to the Philistine. He said, today, the God will conquer you, and I will kill you, and cut off your head. He didn't hide anything. He pronounced to him. He announced to him. He told you, today I'm going to kill you. That's what you will tell the enemy. You tell the enemy, today you will die. Today is your hand. You sickness, that is you are attacking me. You demon, that is attacking me. You poverty, that is attacking me all the time. Enemies, that is attacking my finances. Today is your hand. I'm going to kill you in the name of Jesus. And then I will give the dead bodies of your men to the birds and wild animals, and they will not know, hallelujah, and they will not know that there is a God in Israel. And everyone assembled here will know that the God rescues his people, but not with sword and spear. This is the Lord's battle, and he will give you to us. Hallelujah. As Goliath moved closer to attack David, David quickly ran out to meet him. You know, David ran to meet Goliath. David ran to meet, you know, Goliath, when he was coming, people were running back, were running away. But David ran to meet Goliath. You will learn to meet your enemy. You don't have to run from your enemies. You don't have to move. Because the enemy has tormented you, so you want to move to another city or you want to move to another place. I'm telling you that you can make the enemy to run, not you to move. Not you to run. It's the enemy to run. David ran towards the enemy and bring him down. The Bible is so good. It's so good, I'm telling you. David trumpeted over the Philistine with only slinging and a stone, for he had no sword. Then David ran over and pulled Goliath's sword from it is shaped, and David used it to kill him and cut off his head. That is how it is. David killed Goliath. It just seemed like that. Your enemy is going to die. Your enemy is going to be destroyed in Jesus' name. The enemy that is cursing you, the enemy that is disgracing you, the enemy that is speaking evil against you, today is their end in the name of Jesus. I pray that every enemy that is waging war against you, waging war against your breakthrough, today, that is its end. They are going to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Nobody knew that David could kill Goliath. Because Goliath was too much, was cursing the children of Israel. 40 days. You can count years you have suffered. You can count how many days you've been suffering. You can count how many months, years you have been suffering in the hands of Goliath. Goliath are the ones who disrespect you, does not want you to do anything. They are the ones who see like God mocking your God. God is not a mockery. Goliath, they are the ones who mock your God. You say you are praying God. What kind of God are you praying? Stop going to church. That is not the God you are worshiping. They mock God. They mock God. But you know what? Today, that Goliath is talking to you. Is going to die in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's look in another scripture from the book of Deuteronomy 23 verse 14. The Bible says, since the Lord your God walks in the midst of your camp to deliver you and to defeat your enemies before you, therefore your camp must be holy, and he must not see anything and incident among you, or he will turn away from you. So in the midnight, we are in the midnight, in the midst, the Lord Almighty will deliver you. In the midst of that problem, where you are being attacked, the Lord will deliver your enemies, will defeat your enemies. Your enemies are going to be defeated by God himself in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, since the Lord your God walks in the midst of your camp, the Lord God is walking in the midst, you know, midnight, in the midst of your camp to deliver you. The Lord is walking in the midst of your life to deliver you. The God is walking in the midst. So when the Lord is walking in the midst to deliver you from the hands of the enemy, those enemies, the enemy that is tormenting you, the enemy that is attacking you, the strong man that is affecting you, who has said that you cannot achieve anything, who are following you day and night, who have been cursing you years and years that you cannot move. Today is the end. The Lord Almighty is going to defeat him. He's going to defeat them. Any situation you are facing, God is going to defeat them in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you that God, thank you, because you will defeat every enemy that is rising up against me, every enemy that is disgracing you in me, in the mighty name of Jesus, every enemy that is mocking you in me, every enemy that is speaking against you in the mighty name of Jesus. That is how you are going to pronounce a prayer pronouncement against your enemy. You say, enemies, that is mocking God in me, I am destroying you today. You have to put them a stop so that they cannot continue mocking you. You know, there is this enemy who does not have respect. They just see, I've told you this before, there was a man, he's white. This man, I was telling him about Jesus. He looked at me, he told me, I need God. Him, he doesn't need God. Because he's wealthy, he's rich, he has money, he has everything. When he looked at me, saw that sincerely I need God, not him. But the man was sick, was walking with a stick. He was so sick, he has cancer, he has so many sickness. Now when I look at him, I said, Mr. Man, yes, you are saying that I need God. But my God is very healthy God. I have no sickness in my body. I'm very healthy. But it is you who need God. God can heal you. No. It's okay. You cannot give the devil to torment you with sickness. And then you say, it's okay. It's not okay. How can you accept the sickness that the enemy has given to you? How can you accept Goliath to defeat you and you are able to defeat Goliath? How can you accept the poverty and you know you can defeat that poverty? How can you accept the demons and you know you can defeat them? The demons that are talking to you, they are nothing. You can destroy them. There's power in the blood of Jesus. There's working miracles, power that will destroy every demon, every sickness, every power of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, God, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I'm going to read to you the book of Hosea 11, verse 10 to 11. The Bible says, verse 10, Hosea 11, verse 10, they shall walk after the Lord. He will roar. He will roar like a lion. When he roars, then his sons shall come trembling from the west. The Lord Almighty, you know, the devil is roaring like a lion, but it's not the lion. When the lion roars, the lion of Judah, Jesus Christ, every demon will run away. Every demon will run away. Those your children that have been scattered, enemy that has taken your children, they are scattered all over. Some of them, they don't even talk to you. Some parents, their children, they have rejected them. They don't talk to them. They don't call them. They have no idea. They don't know where they are. But tonight, the Lion of Judah is roaring. Wherever they are going to come. They are going to run. Wherever they are on the west, in the east, wherever they are, the Lion of Judah is roaring, is calling them. They will come back in the mighty name of Jesus. Your husband that is being taken by another woman, your wife being taken to another man, anything that you have lost, the Lion of Judah is roaring. It will roar, and everything that has run away, it is coming back in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy that is scattering your man, attacking you, the Lion of Judah is roaring, is roar, 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 is roaring. That voice, only that voice will make the enemy to return everything they have. That demon that is tormenting you with dreams, the Lion of Judah is going to roar. Is going to roar. When the lion is roaring, you know, in Africa, we have animals. And the lion kingdom, the original, in the forest, not here where they are engaged. There is their kingdom. Now, the lion, they collect all female. And when they collect the female, then if a male lion come there, this lion will kill them. He doesn't want other male lion. He is in charge of those women, all those female lion. That's how they work. And they will go and kill all the family of that lion who will appear. So the lion has power. Now, when the lion roar, the lion called the Judah, the Lion of Judah, Jesus Christ, every demon will repel. Every sickness will repel away. That's how powerful Jesus is. That's why he's called the Lion of Judah. That the Lion Judah, go understand the lion, how the lion acts. When the lion roars, every animals will run away. They will not stay there. And then when they run, they get confused. The lion gets them and eat them. So a Lion of Judah, Jesus Christ, is roaring, is a roar in your situation, and everything will come to you in Jesus' name. I'm going to pray for you now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am asking, Lord, my Father, to help your people, to forgive them any sin, anything that is working against them. That is not lying with you, Lord. That's not originated from you. Anything that they have done against you, Lord, forgive them. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I pray that God Almighty, King of Glory, Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, I want to thank you and bless your name, God. My Father and my God, let every evil tongue uttering curses and utter evil pronouncement against your life, I command them completely be silenced in Jesus' name. This wicked mouth, evil pronounced against you, I am reversing them. It is you to pronounce evil against wicked, against evil, not evil person pronouncing evil against you in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I command every evil strong man, powers housing your rights and the goodness to be violated, overthrown in the mighty name of Jesus. I am praying that God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord Almighty, to destroy and bind out every strong man. Every strong man running, making your life miserable, to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, my Father, I pray that God brought out and destroyed by the blood of Jesus the record and the archives of every pronouncement and the prediction of false prophets, hindering your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. I want to thank you, Father. I want to give you all the glory, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God. Give me that water. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. You are a wonderful God. In the name of Jesus. God, you are so good. In the mighty name of Jesus. I brought out and destroyed by the blood of Jesus the record and the archives of evil pronouncements and the predictions or false prophets, hindering your progress or hindering your breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. I thank you, Jesus. Jesus, 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 I destroy, I break out and destroy every false pronouncement against you. Anything that the enemy has said against you, I destroy them. I bind them, I render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory be the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Every conspiracy against you, assigned to get your destiny, I command them to scatter. I command them to scatter and be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Expectation of darkness concerning your health, I command them to scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. Expectation of witchcraft power concerning your well-being, I command them to scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. I send them fire and scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God, I want to thank you, Father. Oh, God. Oh, great wind from the wilderness, arise, arise, and go and blow the enemies, blow the kingdom of darkness in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, God. Every incarnation of darkness and death wishes against you, I command them to backfire, 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 backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire in the name of Jesus. Backfire every power of the enemy. Every power of the enemy. Having satanic confidence to curse you, I command them to judge and punished in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. I give you the glory, God. I give you all the honor, all the honor, God. All Eden and places posting Goliath, I command them to be exposed and scattered to pieces in Jesus' name. Every evil voices speaking to terminate your existence, be terminated by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, every evil voices, witchcraft voices, satanic voices speaking against you, pronouncing against you, I am pronouncing against them. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy them. I destroy them. I destroy them. I destroy them. I render them powerless. They will not manifest in the mighty name of Jesus. Those satanic voices, you know, satanic voices, they are the voices that people hear. Sometimes they can hear nobody's calling them. Or sometimes they are making noise. They are making noise against you. They are complaining. They are chanting. They are doing everything to block your ways. I am commanding those evil voices to be terminated and destroyed in Jesus' name. No evil voices will manifest. No evil voices will succeed and manifest in your life in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, God. I want to bless your name and I give you the glory. Weapons of warfare from satanic anointed tongue assigned against you backfire in Jesus' name. You know there is a satanic anointed tongue. And this satanic anointed tongue, they're the tongue that they curse people, they speak very bad about people. They talk, they call you names. When they see you, you have not done anything, but they just call you names. They nickname you. They say you look like your head is so big. You are what they like to cut, and they like to speak wicked and evil. Don't let those mouth to pronounce any evil word. You reverse them. You come against their pronouncement. You destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. You do what David did to Goliath. You don't have to fear them. You pronounce pronounce deadly prayer against them, and they will not succeed. You will weather their mouth. You will command their mouth to be sheep. You can command the mouth to be broken, the teeth to be broken. If somebody is a human being, he is cursing you, he has a bad tongue, and he always curse you. Just tell God to break their teeth so that they cannot have a mouth to talk. You have power, you know. You have power. You pronounce a curse, big one, because you have given. Remember, Jacob, of all the people, Jacob, he cursed his own son, Reuben. Yeah? Even when Isaac, his father, forgave him what he did, but him, he didn't forgive his son. He put a curse until Moses is the one who came to rescue that boy. He could have died and his generation could be wasted. Therefore, I know that we have been given power. Don't let people to manipulate you and control you. You have power to put them on stop. Yes. If you have a problem, call me. I will stand with you. I don't fear the wicked. Wicked enemy are very dangerous. There could be a spirit in that man or that woman controlling you, making them to mistreat you and call names and curse you, and you are watching. You can't watch that way. You have to silence any wicked enemy, any wicked person, any wicked personality. People need to be disciplined. If they don't be disciplined, God will discipline them. God knows how to deal with them. You don't have to worry. Just present them to God. Call God and say, God, listen, this is what is happening. Jesus, this is what is happening. This is the person who is doing to me like this and this. Receive him. Do what you want to do to him. If he can repent, that's fine. If he doesn't repent, that's fine. It is up to the person. Many people will go to hellfire. That's why the Bible says many, 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 many people will be deceived. Even the chosen one. The last days. People, they follow the wicked, evil personality who are deceiving them. All because they are threatening. Now they will continue being abused. You cannot live such a life. You have to stand and say enough is enough. Enough is call a spade a spade. And then your life will change. You can't live under bondage because you are working with a wicked boss who does not have sympathy, who does not know that you have children. You work at the end of the month, you are not paid. That's serious. That is very serious. Do you know some people, they work, when the end month comes, they cannot be paid? So you wonder, what am I going to do? How am I going to pay the rent? How am I going to meet my needs? How am I going to meet my bills? You start worrying, you start thinking, you get sick. Because you don't know when you are going to be paid. I have people like that. People call me and they tell me that, my boss, we have not paid this and this. It is true. Some people are wicked like that. So you pray. If it is a financial pin, your company has been attacked by the enemy, there is no money, that one you can understand, you can pray God to deliver the company. But if it's a wicked who does not want to pay you, punish you, you have to close that company down in the name of Jesus. I pray, you the armor of the Almighty God, smash every evil altar elected against you. I pray that armor of God to smash down every evil altar elected against you in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, God. Loving Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. Lord, I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, God. You are a great God in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, I cover this prayer with the precious blood in the mighty name of Jesus. I cover everyone who has come, who has joined us tonight with the blood of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I thank you. I bless you. I give you all the glory, Jesus. I give you honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Loving Father, I want to thank you. Loving Father, I want to give you the glory. Loving Father, I want to honor you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I commit your people once again into your hand, my God. My Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I worship you, Lord. I thank you, my God. I give you all the glory, my Father. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I commit your people into your hand once again. I plead the blood of Jesus over their life in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray that the restoration to fall upon your people, those who have been fighting, those who have been scattered, who have been bringing the division among them. Lord, my Father, I pray that God touch them. Touch their life, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, I want to thank you, God. I want to thank you for their life. I want to thank you, my God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. I have to stop here. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. The videos are there. There's a lot of videos, and you can help yourself. When you are there on the website, there's some prayers that you can go and read and help yourself. God bless you so much. You can reach us. Our number is 877-241-3420. Our number once again is 877-241-3420. And you can, if this one is not working, if it is engaged, you can always reach us. Our another number is 905-487-7196. 877-247-3420 is free line if you are in Northern America. If you don't have long distance, that is a free line. So you can reach me and I can stand with you by making this wicked personality standing against you in the mighty name of Jesus. We make agreement. We can stand with you and make agreement. Where two or three are gathered together in the midst is there. Therefore, God will come and fight for you. You will have your peace. Don't stand by yourself. You need enforcement. Even when police are going to fight, they don't go by themselves. They go by enforcement. Therefore, I pray that God will deliver you and will give you a partner that you will stand with when you are standing in the gap. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you. See you. Good. See you on Saturday morning. Tomorrow we are not going to have a prayer. Tomorrow, Thursday, Friday, we will not have prayer. But I might come anytime during the day. But the morning prayer on Saturday will be on 8 a.m. And Sunday, 8 a.m. Tomorrow and Friday, I might come time early. I might come in the morning. I might come sometimes. I'm not sure the time I will come, but you will see me anytime. So, bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. See you on Saturday, 8 a.m. or tomorrow. I may come anytime. God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time, people of God. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. I love you. I love you. Take care. Bye. Bye-bye.